stay in here for 12 hours, we won't be back.
No, we won't have to do that for any reason.
One mark clear, 2-4, 24 passengers.
I'll definitely feel free to interrupt and ask them. I won't be offended or anything. I'd rather talk about what you're interested in rather than just rambling on about whatever it is. I'll ramble on about. But that being said, if there's nothing you're dying to know, I can give you a bit of an overview, talk about some mountains, some lakes, some rivers, all that jazz. So we're going up Whistler's Mountain right now, it's called, if you didn't know. By the time we get to the top, we'll be at 2,280 meters, or 7,500 feet above sea level, so not too shabby for 7.5 minutes. Gaining just over a kilometer in elevation, and the temperature will drop about 10 degrees Celsius, so about 10 degrees up there right now, about 20 at the bottom, I think. And this is the first mountain along what's called the Trident Range. So the next mountain is Mara Basin, which is a ski resort here in town for everyone's into skiing or snowboarding. It is closed. It's just a fun fact. You can't actually go skiing or snowboarding. But out to the east, or my right, we have the Maligne Range. So you guys have probably heard of right out here. You guys probably heard of Maligne Lake, Maligne Canyon. They're in the valley just to the left of that range. You can see the valley over there. So the first mountain along there is Single Mountain. At the back of the car here, we have Pyramid Mountain, probably the most obvious mountain in the valley, and that's the beginning of the Victoria Cross Range. With the exception of Pyramid, most of the mountains along that range are named after recipients of the Victoria Cross. And as we go over the tower here, we're going to sway slightly forward and back. It's south of us. It's over the other side of the mountain. And you can see it from the summit. You can't see it from here.
Okay.
But then the old ski lodge. Did you guys see the hostel on your way? Sorry, voice is cut.
Yeah.
See the hostel on your way up the road? That's and the last mountain range I want to point out is the Yellowhead Range. It's probably the most important one. It's there to our west, running parallel to us. Beautiful green lake in French, and it gets that beautiful green color from again from that sediment being in the water.
Is that where the fairground?
Yes, yeah, that's where Jasper Lodge is. You can see the golf course there as well. And then up past that, the other two nice lakes, those are that's Annette, and then the furthest one is Edith. And so there's some beaches there you can hang out at if you feel like it. You can swim, it's still really, really cold though because it's fed by a glacier.
Yeah, we went to Horseshoe today. That was cool.
Yeah. All the lakes are here. Lake Annette's not. It's probably the warmest just because it's so shallow, so it has a chance to warm up. Hibernate for 9 months out of the year before the other glorious 3 months of their lives, of their year, they eat, mate, and whistle. So if you're up here at the right time of year, you'll hear them whistling. They go the same way. There's also pikas, which you probably won't know what a pika is, but if you know Pokemon, like Meyer was Pokemon, Pikachu is a pika, and they look kind of like a hamster with big hair. They're not yellow, they're brown. So Nicole's gonna let you guys out on the left side here. Just at the back there, watch the video.
It's freezing. In a real kind of way.
Hi. going to be going on.
Sasakyan.
Kasalukuyan na pong lalapag natin sa ating